Hello students, in today's lecture we are going to discuss about the moment of inertia of a disc. Now we have to consider a disc, that is the thin and uniform disc. Suppose this is the thin and uniform disc. We already seen that is the compact disc, or we can say that the CD. So this is the compact disc, okay. Now we have to determine the moment of inertia of this disc about an axis that is passing through its center. Suppose this is the axis of rotation which is passing through its center. Suppose C, it is the center for this disc, and IC, that indicates the moment of inertia of this disc about an axis passing through the center. We have to determine the moment of inertia about an axis passing through the center and perpendicular to its, that is the plane. So this is the disc. Suppose this disc, it is having the mass capital M. So capital M, it is the mass of disc. Suppose capital R, it is the radius of, that is the disc. Capital A, that is the surface area of disc, and which is given by, that is equals to, that is pi r square, surface area. Then the surface density, that is the density, it is given by surface density equals to, we know that the density, that is the mass, total mass upon surface area. So capital M upon, that is the pi r square, it is the surface density for this disc, okay. Then how we can determine the moment of inertia of this disc about this axis? So for that purpose, we have to consider a small ring inside this disc. Suppose this is the small ring, because we know that this disc, it is made up from, this disc, it is made up from small such types of rings. A thin uniform disc consists of so many, or we can say that the large number of thin discs of varying radii, or the increasing radii from 0 to r. This disc consists of small rings of such types. So for the determination of moment of inertia of this disc, first of all, we have to consider a small ring. We have to determine the moment of inertia of this ring, and then by integrating, or by using the integration, we can determine the total moment of inertia from the limits from 0 to r. So for that purpose, we are considering a small ring having the suppose radius small r. Suppose small r for a ring. For a ring small r, it is the radius. Suppose dr, it is the width or the thickness of, that is the ring. Dm, it is the very small mass of, that is the ring. Then what is the area for this ring? Then area, it is nothing but the circumference into, that is the width. So that will give the surface area, and that will be equals to circumference, that is 2 pi r, and width, that is the dr. So A equals to surface area for this ring, it is equals to 2 pi r into dr. And by using this, we can determine, that is the density or the mass for this ring. So mass for this ring, that is dm equals to, just like the density, we also determine the density for this ring, and that density, that is equals to mass of ring, that is the dm upon the surface area, that is the A. So dm upon area, that is 2 pi r into, that is the dr. And in this way, we can determine the mass for this ring, that is dm equals to sigma into 2 pi r into, that is the dr. So this is the mass for this small ring, okay. Now we can determine the moment of inertia for this ring. So moment of inertia for a ring, and that will be, suppose IR equals to, that is dm into, that is the r square. Dm, it is the mass of the ring, and r square, that is the distance from the x of rotation. So dm into r square. So this is the moment of inertia for this ring. But the disk consisting such types of so many rings, so we can determine the total moment of inertia. So the total, that is moment of inertia of disk, this total moment of inertia, that can be calculated by using this relation. If we integrate this relation by using the limits 0 to r, then we can consider the total disk. So for that purpose, we can write like this: integration of, that is the IR equals to integration of dm into, that is the r square, having the limits 0 to r. So integration of IR, that will give us the total moment of inertia of disk about an axis passing through the center. So we can write like this: IC, and integration of, that is limits 0 to r, dm. So sigma into 2 pi r into dr into this, that is the r square. But sigma, 2 pi, these are the constant factors. So we can write like this, that is the IC equals to, so sigma 2 pi integration of 0 to r limits r into r square, that is the r cube. So r cube into, that is the dr. Now we are having the relation, that is IC equals to sigma into 2 pi, and by solving this we can write like this, that is r 4, that is the r is to power 4 upon, that is the 4 and the limits from 0 to r. Now we are having the relation for the moment of inertia of disk about an axis passing through the center and perpendicular to its plane, that is equals to, that is sigma into 2 pi, and now by solving this we can write like this, in place of r we have to write capital R. Its upper limit, it is the capital R, and lower limit, it is the 0 1. So on putting the values in place of r, that is upper limit minus lower limit, we can write like this. So this 4, it is the constant one, so you can write like this, that is sigma, so this is the 4, and in bracket we can write like this, that is the r 4 minus, that is the 0. Okay, so this will be, and moment of inertia, then we get the relation sigma, we are having the value, that is m upon pi r square. So capital M upon pi r square, it is the value for sigma. So this pi as it is upon this 2 in bracket, that is the r 4. Now we can write like this, this is the r 4. Okay, so this pi pi, that will be cancelled, and we get the relation, that is IC equals to, that is this r square and this r square, that will be again cancelled. So we get the relation m r square upon, that is the 2, and this is the moment of inertia of this disk about an axis passing through the center and perpendicular to its plane. So in this way we can determine the moment of inertia of disk. Thank you.